Your number one radio. KBC English Service.
It is time for the big conversation on KBC English Service with me, Angela Mwihaki. And this morning, we're going to discuss some of the interesting debates going on at the moment. And we're going to do this through the eyes of one of the country's top social commentators. Tony Mochama is also known by the name he uses in his newspaper column, which is Smitta Smitten. And you know, most people don't know what he looks like. Me, I've just confessed. I've been stalking him for a couple of years. And he writes as Smitta Smitten. He's also an author of several books, which one first being, What If I'm a Literary Gangasta? If I'm a Literary. What If I'm a Literary Gangasta? The Road to Eldoret, A Nairobi, A Night Guide, and the novel Princess Adhis and the Naija Coca Broda. Aki, this guy and his names. Tony is the secretary of the Writers Association, PEN International Kenyan Chapter. And on Twitter, you need follow him at The Real Smitta, capital T for the and R for real and Smitta. That is Smitta spelled S-M-I-T-T-A. Welcome.
Thank you so much. Yeah, it's fantastic to be here.
Now, what do I call you? Do I call you Tony? Do I call you Smitta?
Feel free to swing between both of them.
I shall be the Angie. Pendulum here.
Yes, yeah. I can see someone who's very good in physics.
I was thrown out in Form 1, and let's not have that discussion.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, okay. Too fantastic. Yeah, but okay, cool. So are you Tony sometimes and Smitta other times, or what happens here? You know, like how, what's her name? Beyonce has, you know, Sasha Furious when she goes on stage. So do you?
Sasha Furious?
Yes.
That's Sasha Fierce. Yeah? I'm going to go all Nyanza here. I was going to say Sasha Fierce.
It's all loud. So are you usually, who are you kawaida? No, if I meet you on the street.
I always tell people I'm Smitta only on Fridays. But seeing as we are going into Easter, Smitta, you know, today Thursday, it's like a Friday.
I call Thursdays Thridays.
You call them Thridays?
Yes.
There you go. You are so poetic.
You are so poetic. By the time you guys are done here, man, I'll be telling you about things I'm going to be writing. So tell us now. So kawaida, you're Tony. So we've gotten that cleared. Now, how did the name, how did Smitta Smitten happen? How did we get that name?
Actually, KBC TV used to show a show called Goodness Gracious Me. It had some like Indians living in Britain.
It was Indian people.
There were Indian people, and one of them was called Smitta Smitten, the showbiz kitten. So I sort of appropriated that name. But I thought I was just going to do a one-off piece, and I didn't want to be Tony Mochama.
It's how many years now, Smitta?
Like 12.
Whoa.
Yes, we are in it for the long haul.
I can say, kinda. I mean, you know, 12 years by now, kinda sort of know that. So now, when you started writing it, you know, and I loved how my colleague was like, first of all, how she thought, we're begging you a skirt after this.
Oh, no.
Remember, she's like, I thought it was a chick. What was the reaction initially? Because I remember I only read the pulse because of, you know, how you talk about Vodosky and, you know, you changed everything. You wrote your own language.
Not really.
What I did
was to put
the SKI.
Russian,
you become Ruski.
Russian suffixes because I just come back from St. Petersburg, so I thought it would be fun to play around with some Smenglish, what I call Smenglish now,
which is Smitta English,
but it consists of Engsh
and Ski.
Engsh, what you know?
Engsh is.
The Kawaida language,
like the just you. When you said X, I went X.
Engsh, yeah.
Who is X? Have we met? So if we know if I'm on, we have my people listening and wondering what's this dude on.
So and it was like Engsh is of course English mixed with Kiswahili.
But I added
Russian suffixes to
okay.
it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Yeah.
So, how did people first react to that? Those two rows. I mean, I enjoyed the articles, but what were your editors looking at you like? Dude, are you okay?
I loved my editors then, and I love my editors right now, because they sort of were not comprehending, like, what's going on, but they were happy with the response among the youth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because you know, toys always want to feel a bit like
different,
rebellious.
Yeah.
Yeah, they like their own like secret language and so on.
Mm.
So I was just like, I don't know, like a lingual avatar,
mm-hmm.
who is sort of like creating something which they could associate with. And I'm afraid, I'm pretty sure I'm one of the culprits for the Xaxa.
We shall sue yes. you, because man, that thing is just yeah. just wrong. Now we know who to blame. Yeah. Folks, the person behind that no. XAXA and yeah. oh man. And then instead of saying okay, you just do K.
Yeah.
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 Smitta's yeah. guilty.
Yeah. I'm not saying I'm alone. I'm just saying.
It doesn't matter. We found one person.
Yeah. Yeah. We are one of the godfathers of Xaxa.
Yes. I tell you, that one may, that one you will pay for. May your children torment you with bad language.
No. We don't like xenon and x-rays.
It doesn't yeah. matter.
And we grew up. I can hear Billy Odidi laughing there.
Well, I mean,
we
yeah.
grew up in the era of xenon.
No, but x-rays. Those were compounds that were written like
and
that.
X are so few words. You know, you read the dictionary, X is like one page.
Yeah? But you can
xylophone. So,
you
and after, S, there are too many S's.
In a room yes. with xenon, you yes. you played your xylophone and yeah. you got
X-rayed.
Yeah, okay. Now I need to ask this, because yes. you were always and sometimes I don't. Do you drink as much Vodiski as you talk about?
Trust me.
There's Billy. I was about to deny everything.
Oh, it's been admitted.
But, yeah,
it's official.
But I can hear, you know, the head of radio.
Of the service, yes.
Of the service, very busy. Like I said, I had come back from Russia, so...
The land of wealth, yeah. Where Puaruza put to yes. very good use.
There we go. Yeah. Why make chips when you can make vodka?
Leave my relas. Yeah. We still yeah. need our Puaruza. Yeah. But yes, that's an extra... it's called... What are they? They call yeah. it what? Added... What's that thing yeah. called? Value addition.
Yeah, yeah.
For Waru.
Angie, are you one of those people, you invite people for lunch, eh?
Mm.
Then you've got like an entire cauldron, and then you just sort of throw like cabbages inside.
Well, excuse
then
me.
You throw potatoes,
I will proudly speak of me where
yes.
I come from.
Yes.
As people of the slopes, as a girl born yeah. in Kiabu County,
yes.
we love Warus.
Yeah.
And they are serious, and it's a serious relationship, yeah. and we handle them with care. So leave the potato alone. I love my Waru. Don't come between me and my Waru.
And
on the other hand, I can live without it. So don't worry. You're guaranteed if you come home. You will get interesting variations.
I was going to invite you for French fries for lunch, but there go French fries. But I think your listeners ought to know that things like vodka called spirits,
yes.
because it's monks in 1507 in Russia.
Mm-hmm.
Monks are the ones who first made potatoes into vodka. So they called it, you know, a spirit.
May they live so, long.
Yes. And people spoke in tongues.
Hallelujah. Yeah. And they will be doing yeah, so from today.
That's why they're called spirits.
Uh-huh.
There
I didn't know. That's absolutely. A nice one. Trivia.
Ebu, right.
Now let's see how Angie's going to squeeze yeah. that into some conversation later yeah. on today. Yeah. Yeah. Keep it low. Now, one thing about you is you're very candid about, yes. you know, in your articles, you know, you write about personal issues.
Mm.
I didn't know you got divorced. Now I'm seeing you got divorced. Yes. You know, so do you have limits on what you write about, or do you share literally everything about you?
No, I found it odd always, because I grew up in this house here in Nairobi, but my dad was very kissy, my late dad, and there was no emotion. He was very disappointed in me. I was one of those sort of sensitive, clever kids who like poetry, and my dad was a
you are a omogusi. Hey, tough
yeah.
man.
Yes. And, you know, just very, Kisis will know this, eh? They said you come from Kiambu. Very unemotional fellow, yeah? You know, I never saw him cry. He never used to say words like, I love you.
Excuse me, but I think yes. which generation yes. had parents who said those things?
There we go.
So it may yes. not just be the Kisi. Yeah. I mean, my dad was to come and yeah. start crying or tell me I love you, I'd be like,
yes.
Is there something you need to know? What have the doctors
yeah,
said?
Yeah, exactly. You know? Like you're 6 months left to live
you
or anything.
Know, yeah.
Yeah. But, yeah. So I found that we are a very, like, sometimes emotionally closed society,
mm-hmm.
and also a very like both pretentious and also pretending one towards me.
Mm.
And I thought, why not make my life a book? I've got space. Why not make it an open book?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, people get married in such big, dramatic ways, and a very dramatic wedding.
It was
even on
did.
TV.
Boy.
I was in magazines. I can't remember. It was a drama, True Love.
Mm.
But when you part ways, it's like it's a shameful secret. You know?
Yeah.
It's like a sore under the armpit. And I thought,
where,
you know,
inside underwear would need to be.
Yeah. It could be. I really don't want to discuss.
It's okay. Let's move on swiftly.
So, I thought, because I have other columns like Men Only and the Saturday like newspaper, and I thought, yeah, let's discuss life, you know, just kawaida, not just the way we do on social media. We share our triumphs, but let's also share our failures,
our fears, defeats. Yeah,
our fears.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and. If people don't do it, many people, you know, I'll be one of those. Yeah, I know bloggers do it, but at least they can do it like on a national space, and you know, like Men Only, I think, as a following because of that.
Because you talk about everything. Candor.
Yeah.
So yes, if you're wondering, yes, Men Only is who we have in studio. His name is Tony Mochama, but we know him as Smitta Smitten. I'm trying to balance between the two. Now, so at least for you, there are no holds barred. You'll share what you can, when you can, how you can.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, just because there are people who are going through, you know, good stuff, bad stuff, you know, disappointing things.
Cool, man.
Yeah.
You've encouraged me. Yeah. I shall open my heart.
Right now.
No, yeah, yeah. Right now. It's cool, man. Yeah.
Okay.
Right now, I'm worried about. We'll discuss that one later. I need a vet.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Now, with the emergence of social media, of course, showbiz is available instantly.
Mm.
How have you managed to hang on? You know, your article is still fresh. Guys still look for it. I mean, we've been reading it now that you said 12 years. I won't confess how many I've been reading it, but
yeah.
I've read it for a long time.
You're
how
still
do you
young,
stay relevant? Hey, please,
you're
hello.
Still young, angel,
yeah.
Still young.
So you can see.
Angel, absolutely.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah.
So how do you stay relevant? I mean, this is the serious compare, like to Mesema.
I always say that social media just created like other layers for people to communicate, like personally. Anyone can start a blog, people can do their instantaneous tweets,
mm-hmm.
and so on and so forth. But you will find that, you know, at a wider scale, we've got people like Njambi Mwingai at Standard, who does like the Standard Digital Edition and so on. So even we in media, I'm sure you guys are doing the same. You try to keep, you know.
Yeah, keep up with the times.
To keep up with it. But in terms of now personally, away from the institutional thing to the individual, if stuff is good, it doesn't matter what medium comes along.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It always rises.
It will rise to the top.
To the top. Mm-hmm. It's just a law of, you're the one who's good in physics.
No, it's thrown out in Form 1.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, dear. I don't know why I have this false narrative in my head. So you'll find somebody like Biko.
Yes.
My friend.
Who I love. Yes. I don't miss his articles.
There we go.
Mm.
He has great articles in a, you know, like a Saturday.
Man Talk. Everywhere, wherever you follow him, yeah.
But he's also among the top bloggers.
Yeah, because every Tuesday we're waiting for his articles on social media.
There we go.
Mm.
So I'm not much of a blogger, but people will still go. I'm sure even if I started a blog,
we'd be there.
I would have some followers, and there would be many. So, you know, I always say, bring it on. Technology is good.
It's good for us.
Yes.
Now let's update us now. What's happening? What are you working on right now?
Oh, fantastic! Currently, I'm working on a book called "A Vest for Hermit."
Aki, the names you come up with.
And
a vest for
Hermit. A vest for Hermit.
H-E-R.
A-K-H-M-E-T.
Ahmed.
Yeah.
Wow.
A vest for Ahmed. Yeah.
Who
and
is
and Ahmed is a boy who has been recruited into a terrorist.
He's been radicalized.
He's been radicalized from the internet and he's made the journey to Somalia.
And that sounds interesting.
Yeah. I know one of your presenters, Kainho Kwemba.
Yes, our good friend, literally.
He likes going to the pen president, he likes going to Somaliland. But that's very different from Somalia.
Well, he goes to pursue literary issues.
Radicalized, who knows?
No, I don't think Hainga is going in that direction. But he will have to confess after this.
We'll get him a basement, cold water.
And we'll see what to do with him. We will coerce him.
Absolutely. Mm. So, but I wanted to explore, to try to intimately explore like radical ideology in my next book. Young people who are getting into this sort of thing, like our friend Hakmet, whose name is actually Troy, but he becomes Hakmet. And of course it's called a vest because they usually recruit them to do the very basic things like, you know, suicide bombings.
Yes.
It's not the bin Ladens who kill themselves.
No, it's
these young people.
The KYMs,
and,
yes.
And they promise them camels and virgins.
And yes.
Or virgin camels, I'm not
I like the pun.
Dromedaries. I wanted to explore.
So that's what that is, work in progress as we speak.
Absolutely. Yeah. Right now we are here, but my mind is in a camp in El Hade.
Okay, now this guy can truly, and we said women can multitask. He's giving me conversation and he's plotting on the other hand. Hey, mad skills, I bow down. Now, when you're writing as Tony and you're writing as Smitta, is there a difference in style?
Yes, absolutely. Because, and when I'm doing different types of writing, because people who've read my books are like, sometimes it's hard to believe they're from the same writer.
Yeah.
But I sort of mentally switch character.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, mentally I switch character.
So you're different people in there. How many of there are you? Kwa wangapi uko
na? Our names are legion. Yeah. If you call me by all my names, I'll have to look for a swine of pigs
to send,
dash into them.
All right.
And then, you know, I don't end up over a cliff.
The pigs that will go.
There we go. Yeah.
So your styles are different. Of course, as Tony, you're more serious and you have very good vocabulary, I must say. A very good English teacher.
Miss Amelia Mascarinas. I would give her a shout out, except she's dead.
Yeah, because I have listened to you and your rapport and your collection of vocabulary is very good. But that means you also, and I know, at least personally from stalking him, I've met him in bookshops. That's how I know. He reads voraciously.
You see, there you go.
No, but you do.
I'm inspiring you through osmosis already.
Take a chill pill. You just
unleashed voracious.
No, the words are there. I have them. I had a good idea.
You look it, I don't doubt you. I'm so totally pulling your leg.
So you read a lot.
Yeah, absolutely. Because I always tell people, what else is there to do? Yeah, you find people like in a matatu. Yeah, they're just staring at the back of their neighbor's heads or looking out of the window. When people are, these smartphones, sharing jokes and funny videos. I mean, you can only have so many funny videos in a day. Mm. Why do you want to laugh the whole day? Get into another world.
Read a book. That's the best way to see the world.
Yes.
It is, absolutely.
Absolutely, yeah.
I'm hooked. One I know.
Yeah.
Now, okay, I am a Literary Gangasta was a work of poetry, and it stirred quite a bit of debate between you and some critics. Do you think the conservatives have finally been forced to embrace your radical style of writing?
Yeah, it wasn't. Yes, Angie. It wasn't even that radical to start with. It was just something sort of like new on the scene.
But you see, when something is new, it's different. And everybody's like, what is...
Yeah, exactly. That was 10 years ago. Yeah. Mm. But it has gained a veneer, I suppose, of respectability, because that particular book, even next door at the University of Nairobi, it's being taught by the likes of Dr. Tom Odhiambo.
Now, how does that feel, your books being taught to literature students?
Honestly, didn't really feel like anything.
You don't feel you've figured, you've achieved something?
Okay, it's good.
Hey, everybody would know, but do I say?
No, not really.
It was me.
No. You're not from that side of the world.
I can't help it.
Everybody would know.
I would acquire.
No, it's a good thing. But what I'm really hoping for is I had no doubt that eventually, and I'm making another prophetic sort of assertion right now, you know, we can't stay stuck on Ngugi forever, because Ngugi is like an old cathedral. It's wonderful, but it's a cathedral about neocolonialism,
the pictures,
and Moism.
Yes. You know, we need a voice for our generation.
Precisely. Mm-hmm. We are the country going to the Chinese, being mortgaged till 2060, 2070, maybe for good projects, maybe not, I don't know. Yeah, but, you know, we'll speak, you know, against the Chinese. Yeah, you know, Mzungu is old, white is gone, yellow is in. It's the new sort of like global debt threat. I mean, among other problems, which, you know, the current youth and generation face. So, like a vest for a hermit.
There we go, I tell you. So, of course, if you're just joining us and wondering, what are these people? Who are we? In studio, we have with us Tony Mochama, aka Smitta Smitten. He is a poet, author, and journalist. And, well, now, he also wrote The Road to Eldoret, that was based on the events of the 2007-2008 post-election violence. And how was that for you? Writing it must have been, because that was a very dark period for us. We never thought.
Absolutely. I remember, like, because I was staying in Nairobi West at the time, so I went to there's an Uchumi there.
Yes,
and Uchumi at the time had a lot of stocks
at the shopping center. I lived there.
Absolutely. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I always say East or West, Nairobi West is best.
No, but it's a good place to live after some time.
Absolutely. I left too, and I know why. And we'll not discuss that. Yeah, we won't discuss West. We'll discuss Road to Eldoret. And I wrote that book in a period of 3 weeks because...
Chop.
I was a bit terrified.
Okay.
Yeah, like a lot of people. And we are not even in the eye of the storm.
Mm.
But it was such a strange period.
Yes, it was.
Yeah, because, you know, you'd come like to town, there are all the Robocops on Uhuru Park. Every day, like those first 3 weeks, every day there are people getting, you know, murdered. And... you remember for people who are over 10 years old or 15, when does memory begin? Everyone in Kenya who's over 15 can remember the dark mood in the country at the time.
Yeah, people having to travel, you know, not knowing where you're coming or going from. Yeah. True.
So I didn't travel except to work. What I did mostly was stay holed up in my crib in Nairobi West. Had a lot of wine bottles, And I just started writing because it's my default mode for distress.
Mm.
Yeah. So that book it took me, I remember, like...
3 weeks.
3 weeks, the raw version.
Then,
then, you know, later on we could edit it and so on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah. But I'd said, if it's going to be like Rwanda, they'll find me in the house. They'll find me drinking red wine and writing with my black pen. Before they cut open my black skin and spill my red blood. Yeah.
But that's extremely... Okay, for me, who thinks in pictures, it's very graphic.
Yeah. What were you doing during that period?
I was home, and I remember the first week we didn't even come into town.
Yes.
At all.
Yes.
And then I had to go to where I went to visit the people who had... The guys who had to come, the refugees. I went to Jamhuri Park.
Wow.
And I went to... There was this Karura church.
Yes.
And I was traumatized. Yeah. But there were lessons to learn. And that's why we cannot afford to do that again now.
Exactly. Yeah.
We cannot afford.
Yes. Yeah.
Because
yeah.
it was not me, but the stories and the people I talked to, I was like an old woman with nothing.
Yes.
The and terrible thing.
You can imagine that was not just, one can't say just, but it was like officially just over 1,000 dead. Can you imagine if it was like 10 times
Let's
worse?
Not even think about, we don't want a Rwanda, we don't want
anything. A Rwanda was 1,000 times worse by the math.
Yeah, but you know, even just the loss of one life, you know, it's painful. So just any life,
absolutely.
All lives matter.
So even as we approach elections,
we need to be sober.
All this talk of, you know, that sometimes you find very strange talk on social media and so on.
We're going to do that about how we need to regulate social media. Now, let's move to slightly lighter matters.
Yes.
When you wrote Nairobi A Night Guide, I actually remember reading this, and a critic called it a book about hopping from one pub to another at night. Mm. Really, is that what the book was about? I actually remember reading that and I just checked it.
Yeah. Yes, I remember that queer professor... I'll not mention his name, but he's a very queer character. With certain
that is heavy with innuendo.
Yeah.
Let us leave it there.
Yes. Yeah. But
so what is actually a Nairobi night guide?
It's like a nocturnal guide, like a
so you've talked about where you can go for chipo.
Absolutely.
At midnight, all there are certain shops where we go for chipo.
That is true. From the red robins to other chipos.
I had forgotten English.
So there's an absolute. Thank you. You delivered that one so perfectly.
I didn't get it. Yes. I was sorry. I was thinking on
but I kept thinking, because sometimes I've, you know, we all have foreign friends who once in a while, you know, drop in.
Yeah. They want to know where to go.
And they always, back in the day, they would only go like to either Florida 2000 or Black Diamond in Westlands. Like those are the two places they knew. And even those were the two things you'd find in guides to Nairobi. And I thought, why can't there be a book about where to go?
So what did you tell them? What are the joints?
What
did you
I did was for 18 months I went out every other night. Not every night, but literally every other night.
That's tiring.
It was exhausting. Yeah. These days I say I even got the t-shirt and wrote the book.
I tell you. And you sold the t-shirt.
And I sold the t-shirt. But yeah, I went out for 2012, 2013, half of it, like every other night. And then I selected, like, of course, I couldn't write about, if you do the math, it's like almost 400.
Yeah, you can't hack all of them.
But I chose like 60 of, you know, the most
memorable
and meaningful. And so it's a good book for our city to have. Yeah.
So peeps, yeah, if you're lost, get yourself a copy of Nairobi A Night Guide.
It's only for use at night.
That's it's called, you know, like Nairobi A Night
there we
Guide.
Go. Like those medicines you're told take before you sleep.
Okay.
This one, take it and you won't sleep when you don't want to sleep.
Aha. Uh-huh. Now let's talk about your latest work, Princess Adhis and the Naija Coca Broda. What's that about?
Okay, it's not my latest. It's from 5 years ago.
Okay, but, forgive us, but
2012. But
all right.
But let's talk about it anyway. Yeah. Princess Adhis and the Naija Coca brothers. There's a real life couple, and I'm not scared of slander here because she was very happy to get it. You remember Chinedu?
Yes. And, yes. Our deep West people.
Deep West. In fact, I gave her the book at Deep West, and she gave me a whole bottle of vodka. She was delighted. But I was inspired about people who carry unga across borders.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people who.
And we're not talking about maize mill people.
Yes. Mm-hmm. There we go. Yeah.
You know, right now we are concerned about the price of unga.
Yes, there we go.
When you say unga, now we're thinking unga. Yeah. Maindi tarudi korokorombili ni pesangapi.
This Colombian unga.
Okay, that's the one we're talking about.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And you know, these Nigerians who are all over, like in our society, and you know, sometimes not all Nigerians, but a lot of them, they exist in a strange underground. You're not sure what they're doing here. So, and I was interested about these strange mzungus who on the internet, you start chatting with them, then they say, oh, you know, we'll meet up in Malindi, you know, for certain activities. So that novella, it's a crime noir, wanted to talk about those three problems. Corrupt sort of politicians who enable this thing. So it's very relevant, you know, today.
Even to now, as we speak.
The president and has been talking about it in Mombasa. And it's based next door in Malindi. And those Nigerian brothers. The Oga brother.
Oga, they help you now.
That way. Yeah.
I will take you travel, my sister. Or just need to listen to
exactly.
me.
Exactly. And Princess Adhis goes traveling. She does go traveling. She goes to Abuja. She goes to Peshawar in Pakistan.
Hi.
I won't spoil the story because certain things happen when they go, you know, on trips.
When she go travel.
And then, of course, we have got the sort of, the Germans who come here.
Dangerous.
Yes, who come here. And, you know. You know what they do,
You need to read. Yeah. Yes, it's in between the lines. You need to read it between the covers. Yes. They need to get themselves. So the book is called Princess Adhis and the Naija Coca Broda. Where can they find the books?
They can find it for sure. You know, it's like at TRM at the mall there. They can also get it in this other mall. It's in a lot of malls, capital center.
I like that you're just saying in a mall. Where is it? Oh, yes. I just walk into the mall and say, give me my brother.
Oh my goodness, I did set myself up there. Did I not?
Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, I need to stop doing the German accent. I'll do that if you stop the Nigerian.
I'm not using it. It went.
Yeah, let's get into our Omogusi and no problem. Accents.
Gaki, yeah, I can do yours better.
These books, they're found at the Nakumats there.
So anywhere there's a Nakumat, we can get?
Not everywhere. I specifically mentioned
TRM
mm-hmm. and Capital Center. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But people can also find out from Story Moja. Yeah?
Okay.
If you are that interested in reading this fantastic crime noir, yeah, Story Moja would know.
So how do who is Story Moja and how do I get Story Moja?
Story Moja is a www.storymoja.co.ke.
Yes, because my listeners are across the country.
Yes.
See, to represent. So yeah, if they want. And people like books.
Yes.
So now let's move on to things that are happening around here.
Yes.
Let's talk about the story of Alcoblo. Mm-hmm. Now people have been celebrating. What are your thoughts on this Alcoblo? It's now illegal. It's we can't use those rules.
Yes, that is. I was very anti Alcoblo myself.
Why?
Yeah, because I thought it was very unhygienic.
Okay.
Yeah. That's
That's it. That's the crux of it.
That's the PR reason.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I was not a big fan of it. And so...
But how do we regulate? Because like Roho Safi, we know this is long weekend. So mischief is going to start today.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
You know? And I'm going to get to see them tomorrow morning driving to work. That's when you're meeting guys. Because normally I'm coming here at 5.
Yes.
That's when guys are going home. You meet people on the road and you're like, hallelujah. You pray for yourself.
Yes, that is, I hear you. But, you know, NTSA have a problem on their hands.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because it's like people who only had a nuclear weapon and now it's been taken away and they don't even have a rungu.
They're
just there.
You just pulled a PLO here. That's it's like killing a mosquito with a hammer.
Alcoblo.
But why do we have beef? Alcoblo is used in the UK, it's used in the States, it's used in other parts of the world. Why do we have such beef? For real. Simple.
I think we have an anti-authority sort of thing. It's because, you know, you find those people are having a good time, which is our Kenyan thing.
Yeah, yes, but we should not abuse the alcohol and be a threat to other peeps.
That is so true. But, you know, there is friendly fire. Some of this is just collateral damage of Kenyan merriment. So you find people living like the... You know, you leave a public reminisce at Wilson Airport, and there's a bunch of people in yellow
waiting for you outside
like killjoys.
Like the way you decided to use Langata Road, because my guest yesterday used the same street. He was like, Langata Road, honestly, there's a pub every 5 steps.
Yes. Yeah, we are a drinking nation.
So therefore,
yeah.
So how do we regulate? Because we need to moderate, because when people refuse to discipline themselves, we need to put them to task. How are we going to do that?
Yeah, and TSA, as I'm I understand. Yeah. Mentally, I understand them, but my heart is not with them.
Could you
maybe
be?
Maybe you should buy
PR skills,
cameras, and so on. Yeah, and make people walk in straight lines.
Or do the
lines.
Test of straight line and hold your nose.
Yes,
and
which they do in America and so on. Maybe they need that, and then they document them on little handheld cameras.
Unaongeza budget. Now, of course, now you're beginning to sound like people have been saying that the reason why so many people, there's beef here, is because many prominent people have been nabbed through Alcoblo. Yeah. And therefore, you and them are determined to get rid of it.
Yes. It's been gotten rid of.
Not entirely, because they have said the Traffic Act will still happen.
Yes.
Those rules regarding drunk driving will still apply. Mm-hmm. But NTSA says, Shaurienu, you're still going to have to taste this thing. You still have to use it.
But NTSA, are throwing an illegal tantrum. It's been, the court is the arbiter of law in the land, and the courts have said no. So NTSA has absolutely no leg to stand on. Forgive the pun. They have no leg to stand on, and I would advise all drivers to just this Easter to refuse, say no.
Wait, that
it's illegal.
Now, can you add a disclaimer to that?
Yes.
After we've done that, can we also tell them to refuse to drive if they have drunk?
Yes.
I mean, kindly, please.
Please
save
don't
us.
Do
we
that.
Want to be safe.
No, absolutely. Please don't do that.
Now, let's move to more holy matters. And the other big debate, of course, is from a man called Gwada Ogot. And he's been making news, you know, on his campaign to legalize marijuana. Do you think he has any basis for this campaign in your view, or is this just seeking attention?
Angie, we should sing the song. Police in helicopter, looking for marijuana. Now there, I may be a bit pro-alcohol, but I'm very anti-bang. Yeah, because I think marijuana makes you stupid in the long run.
Mm-hmm.
So Gwada absolutely has no point. These people who say that it's medicinal,
but they claim it's good for cancer management. Somebody also, what's this thing for your eyes? If you have some problem with your eye, it's very good for it.
Cataract.
No, and pain, and I remember.
I mean, that is a total and absolute crap. It may be good, but it's like saying vodka is good for cancer because when you drink it, you feel happier.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Everything can be good for something, but it's not on the official list. I mean, there's cancer medicine.
Yes.
It's not that marijuana is the one that will tip the scale.
And cure you.
Exactly.
It's for management.
Yes, that it's for pain management.
Mm.
They are pain-killing drugs.
Mm.
Yeah, that these Wazungus keep making and the Indians keep imitating, which is excellent. For conditions. So these are people who just want to feel high and stupid. Yeah, because marijuana does make you a bit like slow,
slow. And of course, he's citing places like, you know, okay, right now we know the states, it's happened, Israel, Australia, Canada, and of course the Netherlands, where I even have cafes and everything.
Yes, yeah, but do we take legislation from other countries? Why don't we then say women can't drive because that's the law in Saudi Arabia?
Ain't happening.
It's stupid. Imported legislation is it's a ridiculous concept to say that because it's happening everywhere or somewhere, you know, selective. You can always find any law.
Now, let's move on to, you're a big sports fan and you're a Chelsea supporter?
Absolutely.
You're for life.
I have a daughter called Chelsea.
That's taking it to the other level.
And she's not named after the Clinton's daughter.
But most of the people don't even know that they don't know Chelsea's name.
Or the place in London.
Okay, so she's the football team.
Chelsea Football Club.
Poor child. Daddy, why did you think of my name? Because I like football.
Yeah.
Okay. I need to have a chat with her. Now, do you bet?
No, I don't.
Why?
Honestly, because I find it would spoil my game.
Okay.
I enjoy the pure passion of just supporting
of the game, the thrill.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't need a reason. I loved Chelsea, the team. I've loved it for like 13 years. Yeah. And I don't need incentive or disincentive. Some people even bet against their teams.
Yeah, no, okay, that's wrong. But what do you think of this betting mania we have? And do you think our imposing that 50% ban is going to change it?
Angie, what I think is that, you know, betting, to answer your second question first, no, it won't change it, because betting is an addiction. So what, you know, I have not stopped drinking because they put Syntax on Smirnoff.
Yes.
It's disgraceful, from 400 bob a quarter bottle to 600, yeah? So people, the companies will pass the cost on to the
consumer, right?
And the consumers, because they're addicted, are just going to dole out
to
more
dig
money.
A bit deeper.
Yeah, they'll start, instead of betting 100 shillings, they'll bet like 200-300 shillings. And the sad thing, and this now goes to your first question, is I find that the poorer people are, the more they bet.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's just a phenomenon that I've noticed because the money is meaningful. If you bet 100 shillings. And you stand, I mean, 1,000 bob, and you stand maybe to make either another 1,000
or
another
5 G's
or 5 or to lose it, you'll do it. The equivalent, I was just talking with Billy Odidi, is Odidi would say perhaps that Odidi really take 10,000 shillings from his pay and say, this weekend I'm going to go and bet because, you know, I hope to get
a meter, 2 meter.
That thing called
the jackpot, the whatever.
Yes. So you find, sadly, that the card generally is that 300 shillings is worth it. Eh? So the people who can least afford to bet
are the ones who bet the most.
Mm. And there's a betting place, I don't want to name it, but it's right next to City Market.
I was waiting for that.
That thing, I entered and it smells. The first day I walked in, because I was doing a story on this betting, and it's very close to I&M. When I walked in, I was wondering why it's smelling of fish. Then I discovered so many those people.
Oh, the guys who bring in the fish to the market.
The fishmongers.
Yes.
Yeah, are there with their 100 shillings that are with blood of fish, and they leave the smell there.
Mm.
Yeah. So you can imagine this fishmonger, the 200 shillings is making daily, perhaps, or 300.
And he's losing half of it.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, you can imagine the fishmongers' wives.
Are suffering.
Yes.
The cost of living is harder for them.
There we go.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, everybody knows that you love all things Russian. Now tell us, what this Toro? Do you think Russia really interfered with the election of Trump?
No, absolutely. Absolutely, Angie.
Absolutely what? Yes.
They did. Yes. Fancy bear sponsored by the KGB. Hackers. The Russian hackers got into the Democratic National Congress system, and they kept putting out, you know, information and disinformation.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you believe that? So that one is definitely there.
Where did WikiLeaks get that entire dump, you know, about from Clinton emails being reinvestigated?
So it was
Vladimir Putin wanted Donald Trump in power in America.
So is this a bromance going on here or what?
It's beyond a bromance.
It's a
It's the president of America is absolutely entranced by the president of Russia, and it's fake right
so
now.
So it is Trump who's entranced by Putin.
Yes, he is. And
it's not the other way
around. They're pretending that they are quarreling.
This serious, Toro?
Yes. The showbiz. Yeah, they sent 59 missiles. And then the runway, they destroyed 20 aeroplanes, and the runway 20%, it will be fixed, they said, within a week.
Mm.
Yeah, it's just that the media was catching up with Trump and his association and his associations with oligarchs. Yeah.
So is this like a biashara transaction,
like
or something?
It's like a spy novel thing.
Fiction. Well, they said sometimes truth is stranger than fiction.
Yes. Yeah. Me, I think they have got something on Trump. Eh?
Mm.
I think when he used to go for those beauty pageants in Moscow.
There was more than beauty going on.
I think, because the Russians spy on you all the time.
Mm.
Yeah. All the time. And, you know, why wouldn't they spy on some billionaire? You know, when it comes to Moscow, I think they have compromising material.
Okay, now let's talk a little about, you've talked to us about your love for Chelsea. Do you support any Kenyan club?
I used to support Shabana.
Shabana FC.
Yes, and they are still there.
Yes, somewhere. I think they were relegated. I think they're in the lower.
Thank you so much. Yeah. So my love affair with Shabana reignited because my dad used to take us to watch, because I grew up in Nairobi West. Used to take us to watch, you know, at Nyayo Stadium.
Mm.
But, you know, when teams get relegated, I'm not going to go running around in Bomet and Kisii and Embu, wondering where this relegated
you
team.
Need to be in the
so Shabana,
of Nairobi.
I am with you in spirit.
Okay.
Yeah, when you come back to stadiums where we can watch,
you shall be back.
We'll be there.
Now,
yes.
This big Toro, but this corner, this Toro of Kenyans and Nigerians.
Mm-hmm.
Eh? Oga brother come for show. No, he come for what they call it. He makes a visit. What was it supposed to be? An appearance.
Yes.
And Konyan people make a lot of noise.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
So let's talk about this.
I love your accent.
Huh? I've been practicing,
it's so authentic.
I don't say how I got the accent.
Yeah.
I just watched too much Niger movie. So, of course, the latest scandal is Burna Boy, who engaged in an angry exchange with Kenyans on Twitter. Yes. He even called us peasants. Yes. You know,
I mean,
what is this madness we have? You know, I mean, it was, I call him Davido, his name is Davido.
Yes.
He was the first dude.
Absolutely.
Then Brenna here, Sijui comes and then starts calling us peasants. And I love one comeback. Kenyans were like, first of all, Kwenu Wakuna Stima, what's your English?
Yeah.
But what's this thing with us and Nigerians? You know, are they overrated or do we have expectations that they can't meet?
This bangy boy first.
There we go.
Bangy boy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. First of all, who calls people peasants? Eh? Yeah, that's so Marxist. Eh? It's so 1977. Eh? Yeah, it's so Ngugi wa Thiong'o.
I like that.
Peasants. Eh? It's just ridiculous. But and then saying that he'll buy, you know, a radio station and shut it down.
Yeah.
But this arrogance from Nigerian comes. We've overindulged. Is what I say. Eh? We are like they think we are their cultural backwater. You know, I was just telling Kainga, there you can go to Bungoma somewhere and you're from the city.
You go to the Bundus.
Yeah, to the Bundocks. And you know, you're thinking these natives don't know anything. Yeah, but it's because our content is so, you know, from, like you just said, you watch Nollywood movies. Yeah, you just admitted that.
No, that's why I got the accent from. I didn't say I'm a big fan.
Yes.
The same way I watch certain movies just before, and I'm like, technically.
So it was your training session. Yeah. So Nigerians are just, you know, Kenya has become like their cultural colony.
We've been colonized.
Yeah, we are being culturally colonized. They look at their music. It's just here, 70%, 80%. So why wouldn't they have contempt? Because masters always tend to have, most masters, contempt for, you know, their servants or subordinates. So Burna Boy just... you know, yes,
but what, he was coming to be seen. He was coming for an appearance. He wasn't coming for a show. Was he coming for a show?
Huh?
I don't know. Me, I didn't even know about the story. Like, it's okay, OT.
Yes. But, you see, he could have handled it better. There's a way to, like, explain. Yeah? KOT lash out at you.
KOT is, you people, you are
a huge dog. Yeah? Yeah? But, you know, when the dog comes after you, when Angie's after you, don't smack her in the face with the newspaper. Because she'll bite you. Sometimes you pat the head, eh? And then say, good doggy, doggy. So Bangy Boy should just have explained the circumstances, which could have done on Twitter. Could have said, you know, my Kenyan, you know, brothers and sisters, this is the situation.
Well, my visit was simply technical. It was not a show, whatever, simple.
And then the story would have died there. But now when you start abusing people, that you look at these peasants, yeah? But maybe you had smoked a bit of Bangy.
No wonder we don't want it legalized.
Yes.
Yeah. But also, that's also a sad reflection on our music industry. Mm-hmm. I mean, what is our problem? We have good talent. Mm-hmm. I mean, really, let's be honest. Mm-hmm. We know there's not just Sauti Sol. We have so many others, Jungashi. We have so many young people coming up.
Absolutely.
What is our problem? Yeah. Ikasumba, what is this problem where we have to have these guys?
Yeah,
why don't we
get excited? I like Tim Tida, for example.
Yeah.
In our SI ways, can you please say Inaweza? Inaweza? In our SI ways.
What's our problem? Because we have serious talent.
Yes, yes. I think Kenyans, it's just that thing of prophets at home.
No one wants to listen to you.
Yeah, people just think like, we've always been an accidental country anyway. Yeah.
No, when you say accidental, what are you saying?
I'm just saying the British landed here. They wanted their capital in Masaku. Then the train got, Lunatic Express got stuck here down railway. Even where you are based is where the first street was. So Jim Zungu is in Norfolk waiting for money. Then things start cropping up. So, yeah. A Western obsession. It started with aping, what we used to call aping in the 80s.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and now we just like anything, it's bongo flavor. Kama ni bongo flavor.
But bongo flavor nzuri yavutia ndugu na kuambia maneno, shairi kabisa.
Unaona.
No, bongo, seriously, the lyric, the poetry behind it, the words.
Yes.
It's amazing.
Okay. You'll translate for me.
Ujaskiza?
Sometimes these are the words I am not...
Kiswahili is foreign language.
No, it's local, but theirs is.
Nilenzito, waomba house.
They might as well be speaking Ukrainian.
Yeah. For you, Ukrainian is close to Ruski. I mean, it should be easier for you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's, I think, is the problem.
So we need to start owning and loving our own.
Yeah, we should.
But also, I think quality. We also, okay, as much as I'm saying we have really good musicians, we have really whack, and I don't mean in a nice way. We have some chewing gum music. You know, some songs that just don't. Fruity Loops. Yes. To songs you just wake up. Like the one we were dissing, we shall not name. The one we did not like of all sizes.
Manyake.
But you know, some people,
that one had poetry. Because when you see like about the butchery and so on. I had Timothy the other day say that umeni uwa kwa hiyo ni kuite mochari. Ukona nyama kwa hiyo ni kuite butchery. So, you know, it's our humor. We need to appreciate it instead of dissing it. Yeah?
Okay.
That's part of why Smitta is here. You know, Smitta, as Smitta, I always say, yeah, please see some of this humor. You see that you've laughed.
No, I mean, I look at everything. I always look for something good in some things. And my humor's on another line. I get things before you.
You have been cracking me up throughout the show.
Thank you. So I can be funny.
You need to do even a comedy show.
Thank you.
You are funny.
It's been a fun. Watch the space. Angie the comedian is coming up.
Listen to this, please.
Now, Easter. Mm-hmm. What does Easter mean anything to you? In the year 2017.
Yes. Well, there's a crucifixion tomorrow. And then.
Okay, no, there's a biblical armor. That's not in
you. There's a chilled out Saturday. And then there's the risen Christ on Sunday. Yeah, it's just, you know, one of these holidays.
So for you, is it a holiday or do you believe?
It's a holiday.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not really big on, you know.
Doctrines.
I like Christmas and so on. Because, you know, people are just in a good mood because they're not going to work. Yeah, but I'm not very big on the whole, you know. Yeah,
this part right now. But what do you remember about Easter?
Oh yeah, of course. Yeah, it was very. I remember.
What was the biggest thing about Easter?
Chickens would die.
Yes. Safari
and they would die for us.
And they would die for Aki.
Yes. Yeah. The blood of the chicken during Easter was shed.
The Catholic in me is cringing
for the
at your choice of words.
Yes, yeah.
So Chrissy, so Easter was cuckoo.
Yeah, absolutely.
Safari rally. I was waiting. How do you forget the biggest thing
about being here? That was, and you know, like I said, I grew up in Nairobi.
Exactly.
West.
So you got to see the cars. KCC.
They would just speed past. And then
on the way to Costco.
Exactly. And would spend the whole Easter. The entire April holidays, being like Joginda Singh, making cars
Shakameta.
with Shakameta, yeah.
Some of us have just confessed how young we are.
Yeah, I know. I wonder who this is making sense to, eh? Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, they would make like cars out of like blue band teens and
Tetra Pak, even slippers were
slippers
for tires.
And then later you are smacked, but you don't care. Because where are your slippers? They are tires.
You guys were good. You're taking children's slippers. It was the folks asking if people stole the Paro slippers because then you could make more tires.
And that was. Don't kids miss that these days?
PlayStation.
Because, like.
They sit in front of the idiot box all day.
Exactly. That's so not being together, you know. And I think, you know, and even if we are betraying an age, there was that a beauty to that sort of childhood.
It was real
with all the neighboring kids. You know, you grew up like
an extended clan.
There we go. Yeah, wonderful for socialization. Yeah, instead of being like a one-person massacre on some video game. Yeah, you're just shooting people. What are you planning to be when you grow up, Al-Shabaab?
I like this. So there we go, man. Time flies when you're having a very good time.
Wow.
Absolutely. So in studio we had with us Tony Mochama, also known as Smitta Smitten. And he's also the author of several books. What If I'm a Literary Gangasta, The Road to Eldoret, Nairobi, A Night Guide, the novel Princess Adhis, and the Naija Coca Broda. And he's also working on?
A vest for
Hakmet. Yes. That Gina has just cooled me log. Now, Tony is also the secretary of the Writers Association, a PEN International Kenya chapter. And on Twitter, he's at The Real Smitta. Smitta spelled Smitta. It's been awesome.
It's finally so fantastic. And so the next link is going straight from Angie to Aggie. They do sound like a pop band, don't they?
We cool like that.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's nice to finally hang out with you. Like I said, wonderful. I have stalked him. I bumped into him in bookstores. The nice thing about you is that you always like, you'd always say hi. Yeah. In my head, I'm like, that's Smitta.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, he doesn't know who I am.
Well,
that's
Smitta. I am a fan now.
But it's nice. I've had fun. My brain thanks you. We have traveled greatly.
Yeah.
But before we say kwaheri, people need to read. Can we please just emphasize the need, especially for young people?
Yes.
Young
people, yeah. Please read. You'll travel to other worlds.
Yeah.
You'll have fantastic communication skills. You'll be able to talk better to your bosses and to boys and girls. And I would recommend two of my books, of course.
I hope it's the ones in the proper English.
Yes.
As it should be. Queen's English.
Absolutely.
You know, as it should be spoken.
Angie?
Mm?
Thank you. I would recommend Meet the Umtitas, which is about, you know, growing up in the hood, and Run Cheche Run, which is about, you know, a girl in Eldoret.
She's a racist.
She's a racist.
Definitely. Yes, my mother ran, my father ran, we ran. Excellent.
Cheplocking. Yeah.
So those are for young people?
Yeah.
You're going to have to tell them again. How can we get these books?
Oh, these books, they're available at... why am I speaking a Kalenjin accent?
I don't know.
They're available at almost every textbook center.
Cool.
Meet the Umtitas and Run Cheche Run.
Okay.
For high school students in, April holidays.
Cool.
I mean, what are you doing if you're not reading?
My nieces and the nephews.
Yes.
I wish Auntie shall get you books to read too.
That was Night Runner with me, Angela Mwihaki. Remember to follow us on Facebook at KBC English Service. On Twitter, we are at KBC English. And on YouTube, look for the KBC English channel. And on Twitter, I am at Angela Mwihaki.
This is KBC English Service.